Good morning, everyone. My name is Ethan Beard. I lead the Spring Initiative over at Ripple. I'm kind of going to adjust what I'm saying on the fly. I'm only going to just speak for a couple minutes. I really just wanted to provide some big picture of what we're working on at Spring and really provide some context for all of you here. Thanks to all of you. Everybody's showing up here. Thanks again to the team that organized it. A lot of people have been working hard. I know everyone's got busy schedules and everyone's working really hard. And so we're really excited to have such a great representation of companies that we know well, developers we know well, and some whom we don't know at all, and are really excited to have new members here at this group. So a little bit on Spring. So Spring is Ripple's ecosystem initiative. And we're a little different from some of the other ecosystem efforts that are going on with some different blockchains and companies. And I would say the primary reason is we're very much focused on interoperability. And so for us, we're not trying to build an ecosystem of people that are locked into a single technology stack or locked onto a specific platform. What we're really looking to do is to build a movement around of people who are looking to build out the internet of value. And while we do, we invest, we do strategic partnerships, we build technology, when we invest, we're really not looking for returns. That's not our objective. We're really looking to pull together this group and to pull together this ecosystem. And in many ways, a lot of our efforts are on kickstarting a marketplace and kickstarting a network and building out both supply side and demand side. And for us at Spring Interledger, it's our highest priority that we're focused on. I think for when we think about interoperability, for us, it's not a question of if, it's a question of when. I think we believe we're certainly not maximalists, and we believe that there will continue to be more blockchains, there'll be continue to be more currencies, there'll be continue to be more and more tokens. And so interoperability just seems like it's a no-brainer. It's where the world is going. And I grew up playing hockey in my backyard. I tell my team often, I'm like, let's skate to where the puck is going. And it's very clear to us, at least, that the puck is going to a world of interoperability. At the highest level, I think we're actually on the verge of a pretty massive transformation. As all of you know, for the first time, we can move money. We can actually move value with technology. And that's really a fundamental change. And the people in this room, all of you, are aiming to really transform the world and transform the way that money moves by adding money as this base layer in the tech stack that we all work on. I've been building technology products for a long time, decades. And in many ways, I think that if we had a technology like Interledger and had technologies like blockchains and cryptocurrency, all of the products that we use today would actually be using them in some sort of way. We may not see it as everyday users, but at the fundamental base level in the tech stack, we would be using things like Interledger, we'd be using digital assets to move money because it's so much more efficient. And so with interoperability, this goes beyond any one stack, it goes beyond any one company or any one currency. If we think about it, traditionally, the world of finance has really existed in these silos of financial institutions and silos of payment networks. And these silos, they basically extract rent and they profit from the friction that are in all of these networks and the friction that they add into the world of payments. And so Interledger, I think, has the potential to democratize the movement of money, to both break down these silos, but also to bring these silos together and unite them and fundamentally change the way that money is moved all over the world, as Evan was speaking to. And personally, I get excited about this because I think this can have a profound impact for people all over the world. It really can change people's lives pretty significantly. History has shown, if we look out, as you remove friction from networks, you see a tremendous increase in the volume of activity across those networks. So if we think from Pony Express to mail, if we think from telegraph to telephone, if we think from landlines to mobile phones, or from cash to credit, every time that you remove friction from each one of these networks, you see exponential increases in the volume and the activity that goes on there. And importantly, what you see each time is you see the creation of new companies and businesses that focus on delivering value to the end users and create some of the world's largest and most successful companies. And that's where I think we're on the verge of. All of you in this room are a part of the same sort of revolution by building on Interledger. So we at Spring, we really want to support this ecosystem and really want to work to build out Interledger. More tangibly, we're focused on a couple of key things for this year. First, one of our goals is to have 1,000 active Interledger nodes online by the end of the year. we're quite small at the moment, but I think we all can do this together, and that's definitely a big focus for us at Ripple and at Spring. Second, we really want to work with partners such as yourselves to build out specific use cases, kind of full stack use cases that we think are most applicable at this stage of Interledger. So Evan touched on a few of these. I'll repeat them again. We'll probably talk about them a bunch over the course of the next couple of days. One is microtransactions. One is e-commerce. Another is P2P payments. And then the fourth being around currency exchange. And so we're really looking to have companies that are not just Interledger companies, but our product companies that are P2P companies, that are e-commerce companies that are building on Interledger. And we want to find and identify partners that can work together in this space to build out some of those full stack experiences. And I really think that together we can make this happen. So there are lots of members of Spring in this room. If you work on Spring, can you just raise your hand quickly? Please come talk to us. We definitely want to talk with you all. So we look forward to engaging with all of you over the next 2 days and going forward in the future. And so again, thanks for taking time out of your busy schedules to spend time with us, and look forward to the next couple of days of working and building. Thanks all.